Hi, my name is George Roberts. I'm a farmer here in Southern Peoria County in Central Illinois. And today is April 20th and I'm no-tilling beans behind the Calmer BT chopper as well as a slowdown kit and beveled deck plates on an old John Deere 843 corn head. And it sits in front of a Case IH 7010 combine. And it's April 20th, literally a little early to be planting beans, but the conditions out here are about as perfect as they can you can ask for. The ground is dry, it's fit, and it's planting really, really good. I'm standing here in front of my planter. It's an old Kinsey 2600. Set up very old school. Nothing real fancy on it, not a lot of bells and whistles. Just basically got a typical no-till colder and some aftermarket closing wheels. And because the BT choppers do such a great job in chewing up the residue and the corn stalks, planting into straight no-till is a piece of cake. You know, when we think about cost of products, you know, we think about the, you know, initial investment as well as the return on investment. And then another thing I look at a lot is the cost of ownership. And that can be simply defined as what does it cost to buy something? What's it worth when you're done? How much does it cost to keep it in the field? And how many acres did you put through it? So for my corn head, for example, it's this No 843, a 1983 model. It's worth about $5,000. So cost of money right now is almost at zero. So my cost of ownership for the value of the corn head is basically at zero. Depreciation is at zero because the value of it is today, same as tomorrow, same as 5 years from now. So my only cost is maintenance and repairs. So for less than a dollar an acre, is my cost of ownership for owning my corn head, and that would include all the Calmer upgrades for the life of the expected of the product. So for less than a buck an acre, I can chew up corn stalks, pick clean, not overload the combine sieve, and able to pull in with a very generic, non-special planter and do a wonderful job of no-tilling beans into the old residue from the previous fall's corn crop. As you can see here, I'm going to walk around and just kind of look on the ground real briefly, see what I've done and how nice a job this is doing. I'm on the end rows here, so the amount of residue is not quite as heavy as it would be into the field. But as you dig down here, you can see there's no residue pinched in the corn row. And you can see the beans are running about an inch and a quarter, an inch and a half deep. And the conditions are just excellent. And a lot of that's got to do with the BT choppers taking all this old residue, chewing it up, splitting it up, and getting it all decomposed. So a very generic, very old school planter can come in and do a fabulous job of planting. So just in conclusion, you know, with the cost savings of time, with the combine time, tachometer hours, diesel fuel savings, let alone in the spring, I'm able to come in and pull the planter in one pass and do a fantastic job of prepping myself for a great yield and a great harvest.